Today in this shop, we are going to be using Forscan to configure an electronic power steering rack that's been replaced. This vehicle was brought to us after having the steering rack replaced, and it's here to have the electronic side of it configured, so let's go ahead and get into it. We are going to start by clicking on the connected vehicle icon in the lower left corner. Once we've clicked that, it's going to identify the vehicle by the software that's contained in the PCM, and then it's going to search the networks on the vehicle for modules that are connected. Once it's finished searching for modules on the network, it's going to ask us if we want to save the profile for this vehicle. It's not something I'm planning on working on again, so I'm going to select no. Let's take a quick look at the DTCs in this vehicle, and I'm going to do that by selecting the DTC icon at the upper left. In the ABS module, we have a low battery code because everything has a low battery. We are going to ignore that one, and in the power steering control module, we have an initial configuration not complete code, which basically means a rack has been installed in this vehicle and it's never been configured to the vehicle. The as-built data has never been changed. I'm going to click on the sixth icon down on the left side. It looks like a little microchip, and that is going to open the configuration and programming screen. From there, I'm going to select power steering control module as-built format, and then I'm going to click the run icon at the bottom left of the screen. I'm going to click OK on the warning message that says changing configuration data can totally screw up your car. On this screen, what we're looking at is the configuration data or the as-built data that's actually stored in the power steering control module, and that module is built into the rack itself. I'm going to go ahead and click on the load factory as-built button at the lower left, and what that's going to do, it's going to download the correct as-built file or configuration file from Ford for this VIN number. I'll click yes, I want to download it, and I do have an internet connection. And we have an operation completed successfully message. I'm going to click OK. Two of the lines of the as-built file have changed from what they previously were, so let's go ahead and click write all. I'm going to click yes at the Are You Sure message. And we have a blocks program successfully message, so I'm going to cycle the key off and back on. And then I'm going to click the stop button at the bottom of the screen to exit out of the module configuration file. Next, let's go back and clear codes and make sure all the codes go away and nothing comes back. I'm going to click the DTC button, that is the second one down at the upper left. And then I'm going to click the clear and retest button at the bottom of the screen. We'll click yes, we're sure we want to do this. And then we'll cycle the key off and back on. And our configuration not complete code is gone. If you found this helpful or interesting, please click like button down below. I've got a lot more stuff coming up, so please subscribe. And as always, have a great week.